Do you want to learn how to set up a quiz in Google Forms, but you don't know where to start? Well, then this video is for you. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And the great thing about Google Forms is that we can quickly and easily set up an auto-graded quiz. So not only can your students or your recipients take the quiz, but they can receive their grades automatically after submitting if desired. We're going to look at all the options available to us as a part of today's video. Now, I'm going to assume as we begin here that you know a little bit about Google Forms already. If not, I encourage you to check out my video on everything you need to know about Google Forms. But here we have a fairly basic, a fairly simple form here, and we're going to convert it into an auto-grading quiz. Now, the first thing that should be noted are the types of questions that you can use and the types that you can't for giving an automatic grade. You are already probably familiar that here within Google Forms, there's a large number of different question types that we can choose and we can use when we are setting up our forms and when we're setting up our quizzes. However, there are only six that we can use to assign points and provide an answer key. And they're listed here, short answer and multiple choice, probably the two most popular or the two that you're going to use most frequently, but we can also use checkboxes, drop down, and also the multiple choice grid and checkbox grid as well. In today's example, we're going to use three of those, and again, including the ones that are perhaps the most common. So first, let's just quickly go through the questions that I have here. The first one is not going to have a grade at all. I'm just asking for their name, right? So it's just a short answer here. And below, I've got a multiple choice question. I've got a checkbox question where I want them to select more than one. I want them to select all the correct answers. And then the last one is a short answer question. However, although I've added these questions to the form, it is not a quiz just yet. What we need to do is come up here to the gear icon, up to settings, and we want to click on the quizzes tab here. Now, everything is going to be grayed out until we make this a quiz. So if we toggle this button here, now we've got a few additional options down below. Here are the defaults. By default, we are going to release the grade immediately after each submission. Now, note, this is not after each question, this is after the entire form is completed. After the entire quiz is given, that's when we can release the grade. But if we don't want to do that, we can choose this option, later after manual review. So this allows you, if you are the teacher or if you are the one who is collecting this quiz, you can review those answers before sending them the final grade. Now, note, if you choose this later option, it's going to force the user to provide their email address because you need some way to send that information to them. The first one, you do not need to do that. That's precisely why I've chosen just to ask for their first and last name. Maybe I've got a class list. I already know who I'm going to be sending this quiz to. And then down below, we have three additional checkboxes that we may want to review in terms of what the respondent, what the quiz taker can see. So the first one is missed questions. Are we going to show them which ones that they answered incorrectly? Do we want to let them know which ones that they answered wrong or not? Maybe you don't want to let them know and you only want to allow them to see that final grade at the end. The second one is somewhat similar, but this one has to do with the correct answers. Do we want to show them which one is in fact the correct answer? If you want to allow that, then you want to leave this checked as well. But remember, in some cases, maybe you are fearful that they're going to share the correct answer with someone else in the class or provide that information to someone else publicly. If you don't want to reveal the correct answer, you can uncheck this box. And then the last one has to do with point values. Now, you can always add point values whether this is checked or not. This just has to do with what the respondent sees. Are they going to be able to see the total points and points received after each question? So depending on your needs, you can check or uncheck these options. Don't forget to hit save before leaving this screen. That is going to allow us to have this answer key and now allow us to convert this into a quiz. All you need to do in order to set your answer key and pick the correct answer is click on the area as if you were editing it, right? As if you were going to come in here and edit. And down below, we now have this answer key. And before we set anything, it's always going to show 0 points. So if I select the answer key, at the very top, it's going to say choose the correct answers. And in fact, here within the multiple choice, I could select more than one. I'm going to save that for my second question because I find most people expect a multiple choice or these radio buttons to be one only. So in this one, the correct answer is Ringo. And I'm going to say that that's worth about 5 points. I don't know how many people are aware of that. And if I want to, I can add answer feedback. I can answer some kind of fun knowledge about that answer, or maybe why they thought it was someone else, but in fact it was Ringo. I'm gonna hit done. And now you can see I have this little checkbox beside it. I can see the point value. And just for my own review, I can see which one is the correct answer. Let's come down to the second question, which is our checkbox question. And again, just to initiate it, I just need to click somewhere within this question to get into that edit mode. And now I can see the answer key. So in this case, I want them to select multiple choices. The question, select all the songs that appear on the Abbey Road album. Well, the correct answer is... the first, third, and fifth. The other two are from the White Album. And so those are the correct answers here. And I'm going to say that this one is, I'll give this one 5 points as well. There's something really important, though, that you should know when you're selecting multiple choices like this. It is going to be an all or nothing answer. So basically, they are going to get 5 points if they select these three correct options. But even if they select two of the correct options and maybe one of the wrong options, for example, they are going to get 0 points. So that's a caveat, but I'm going to show you a workaround. You can always manually change that if you need to. So again, I'm going to hit done. There you see the correct answers and my answer key. Now, the last one may seem a little more difficult. We do have a few additional options here because it's a short answer question. We're not giving them any choices here. They need to type in the question itself. Again, I'm going to click on it to get into this edit mode. I'm going to select the answer key. This one's kind of tough, so I'm going to give this one, 10 points. You don't always have to use these arrow keys. You can type them in, of course, if you want to. So here, I am going to type in the correct answer. And the correct answer happens to be Revolver is the album. But pay close attention here because you want to consider the different types of spelling or abbreviation that the people who are taking this quiz may use. If I just leave this as Revolver with the capital R, it's actually going to mark it incorrect if someone just types in Revolver without the capital. So I can add multiple answers here, multiple answers that I am going to approve. Now, the last option we have here when it comes to a short answer is this check box. Now, by default, it's going to be unchecked. And what that means is that if they do answer something that is different than this, they will still get marked as incorrect, but there will be no point score given, meaning that you have the option to manually come in and adjust or give a point score. If I do check this box, they'll still receive an incorrect, just like the first option, but they will get 0 points. So the way to think about this is that if it's unchecked, it's sort of unscored, right? The question or the answer will be unscored. If I check this, it will be scored. It's going to look at this list, and if it's not on there, then they are certainly getting 0 points. I'm going to leave this one checked in this case because it's a fairly easy answer. You may want to uncheck this if you're expecting a wide variety of answers and maybe too many for you to include here in your key. So I'm going to hit done, and that basically finishes it here with the editing mode. Our quiz is now ready for us to try out. It's ready for us to test out. So what we can do is we can hit this preview button here and let's see what it's going to look like for the person who is actually taking the quiz. It's going to open up in a new tab. I can just put in my first and last name here. Which Beatle tried to quit? I'm going to guess, I know the answer, but I'll just say someone else here. We'll select all the songs that appear in Abbey Road. I'm going to say I know my Beatles stuff pretty well. I'm also the author of the quiz, so I'm going to select those three. And this last one here, I'm just going to say something like, maybe was it Rubber Soul? Something along those effect, and I'm going to hit submit. So notice I can see the point value, right? Because I said that I wanted the respondents to see the different points for each question. But as I answer the quiz, it's not showing me the answers immediately. I have to hit submit first. So now Google Forms will show me the results of the quiz I just took. And no, I didn't do very well, but of course I did not do very well on purpose. The first one was just my first and last name. Here we go, I answered this incorrectly. It's showing me that I answered it wrong, and it's also showing me the correct answer because remember, I left those checkboxes checked within the quiz settings. Here I got the full 5 out of 5 because I answered the three questions, or I selected the three correct questions here. And then the last one here, I guessed incorrectly, and it will show me all of the applicable correct answers. So keep that in mind as you're developing your answer key. And if you allow your respondents to see the correct answers, they will all be displayed here down below as well. Now, how about yourself as the instructor, the teacher, the person who has managed this quiz? Well, here under responses, when we go back to our form, we can see our responses in a few different ways. And you may already be familiar with the responses tab if you've used Google Forms in some other way. I think the one that is perhaps most useful is going through it by question, right? Because if I was to add multiple respondents here, I could see, well, which is the most difficult question on this quiz? What am I going to revise in the future? Now, I can look at the individual results here as well, but what I think is perhaps most useful is that I can come up here and create a Google spreadsheet so I can see all of that data in a way that I can sort it, I can view it, and it's maybe just a little more easier for me to read. So I only have one entry in the sample quiz that we just created, but here you can see there's a timestamp, here's the score, here's the name of the individual. Just imagine if you have 30 or 100 or maybe even 1,000 people who are taking this quiz, you can quickly and easily see all of their scores, their names, when they took it, and their individual answers as well. The last thing that I want to show you here when it comes to the individual responses, though, back in Google Forms, is that you can adjust the point values here. So let's say that someone comes to you and says, they have a good debate as to why Rubber Soul was sort of one of the last albums, or it was recorded very close to Revolver. You could come in here and say, okay, I'll give you a few points here. I can hit save at the bottom, and now that score will be saved as a part of their results. So again, it gives you the flexibility. If you need to make a few additional changes, even after the quiz was submitted, you can still do so right here within Google Forms. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'd love to hear from you next. What other questions do you have about creating quizzes or auto-grading quizzes right here in Google Forms? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.